Acupuncture and moxibustion are traditional Eastern medical practices with a history of over 2,000 years. Many people seek out treatment for pain management and also other issues like insomnia and injuries. However, the exact scientific mechanisms of actions weren't fully understood. But in recent years, efforts are being made to gather clinical evidence and scientific data of the effectiveness of acupuncture and validate them through Western medical standards. Today, we'll focus on acupuncture and moxibustion treatment that has evolved uniquely in Japan.
In recent years, acupuncture and moxibustion have gained attention as a complement to Western medicine. Workshops are being held in Europe and the United States. British acupuncturist Edward Obeidi studied in Japan and obtained a national qualification. He has been practicing for 35 years.
Edward, can you tell me a little bit about the difference between Japanese acupuncture versus Chinese acupuncture?
So, for instance, this is a Chinese needle. Okay. This is an extreme example I'm showing you. And if you have a look here, I don't know if you can see the head.
Yes.
Yeah. And this can be used to cause vibration in the needle. And the needle is basically inserted like this. Yeah.
It's and quite thick.
Yeah. But the Japanese one, and actually I can show you how thin it is. I hope you're going to get this on the camera. Even if I do this, it's impossible for me to put it in. It's that thin.
Yeah.
So in order to put this in, we have a tube. And basically the needle goes inside there and then we tap the needle in.
Chinese acupuncture uses thick, long needles that are inserted deeply, while Japanese acupuncture uses thin, short needles that are inserted shallowly, aiming to achieve effects with less stimulation. Acupuncture is based on the concept of meridians, or keiraku. They are energy pathways believed to run throughout the body, connecting to internal organs. Along these meridians are acupoints. Stimulating these points with needles is thought to regulate the flow of energy, leading to effects such as better blood circulation and pain relief.
And so, for instance, a typical line that we all know about is this line here, which is the large intestine line, which actually goes up to the teeth. And that is connected with the large intestine organ inside. And so by using the keiraku, as we call them, on the outside of the body, we can not only help the local area, so if the arm is stiff or if there's a toothache, we can help, but also it will change the functioning of the internal organs. And how they found that out, I don't know. A lot of trial and experience.
Efforts are underway in Japan to scientifically prove the effects of this treatment, focusing on meridians. This university has an acupuncture department that brings together Japanese specialists.
はい、じゃあ今から右手の合谷に針をしますね。
Kasuya Daiichi demonstrated the effects of stimulating the acupoint, located where the bones of the thumb and index finger meet.
針しました。で抜きます。
Thermography detected a rise in body temperature, not just in the right hand where the needle was inserted. Temperature also rose in the left hand.
血管が密のところの方が反応が出やすい、ね、これ全く同じ反応で一回中枢を介した自律神経反射が起こっている。
The autonomic nervous system.Automatically regulates vital functions such as body temperature, breathing, and heartbeat. One part of it is the sympathetic nervous system, which prepares the body for action by increasing heart rate and other responses. The other part is the parasympathetic nervous system, which helps the body to relax by decreasing heart rate and in other ways. One of the characteristics of acupuncture is its ability to normalize the functioning of the autonomic nervous system. For many years, Kasia has used acupuncture to treat the after effects of stroke.
半身のなんか違和感どうですか？
やっぱりちょっと違和感は残っていることは確かですね。
Kubota Toshihiro suffered a stroke in October 2023. 7 months later, the left side of his body remains paralyzed.
やっぱ顔もそうですかね。
ちょっとこの辺がのこわばりがやっぱりちょっと気になるというか。
Immediately after the stroke, facial paralysis made it difficult for him to speak and eat.There are several acupoints that can help with this. One is in the middle of the eyebrow. Another is at the joint between the upper and lower jaws. They are located along the trigeminal nerve.Which controls sensation and movement in the face. Stimulating these acupoints increases blood flow to the brain, easing general body pain and facial discomfort.
いやもう端的に分かったのは顔のが動かなかった半分動かなかったんですけど、それが動くようになりました。それは劇的に動くようになりました。だからえって感じでした。
He also had sensory impairment in his left arm. It became difficult for him to sense temperature.
前はお風呂入っても半分が冷たかったんですけど、脳外科の先生からも、まあ、治るか治らないかわからない、その後遺症がですね、わからないっていうことを言われて。
For sensory problems, acupuncturists look at how the body's meridians are connected.To decide where to insert needles. This may not always be in the same spot as the affected area. They may consider an acupoint just below the kneecap. There is also an effective point where the bones of the thumb and index finger meet.
まず足と手の電気をかけてきますので。
In some cases, Kasia also applies electrical stimulation to the needles inserted in the arms and legs to promote the secretion of opioids, a substance that relieves pain. Opioids are released by the brain and spinal cord. There are different types with varying effects, such as pain relief and stress reduction.Research has shown that the type of opioid produced in the brain depends on the frequency of the electrical stimulation applied. This graph, based on blood tests, shows the type of opioids that are secreted at different frequencies. At a low frequency of 2 Hz,Opioids promoting relaxation and calm are produced. A high frequency of 100 Hz leads to the secretion of opioids that help balance the autonomic nervous system. Kasia combines various frequencies in treating sensory problems.
震えがこう叩かれてるような感覚があって、マッサージされてる感じですかね、はい、皮膚感覚が鈍いのがなくなるんですよ、はい、それははっきりしてます、はい
7 months have passed since Kubota had a stroke. Rehabilitation and monthly acupuncture treatments have led to a major improvement in his symptoms.
What other applications are there possibly for acupuncture and moxibustion?
やっぱりこう精神疾患、例えばうつとか、あるいはこう不眠ですね、睡眠障害とか、そういう精神疾患の方も、やっぱり脳機能に異常を起こしてきて、まあ、あちこちこういろんな症状が、例えば疲れやすいとか体がだるいとか、まあ、そういう症状を訴えている方って非常に多いんですね。でそういう精神疾患に対しても今鍼灸はこう効果がある、ちゃんとエビデンスも出てきてますし、脳機能も改善して自律神経をちゃんと整えるっていうね、そういう効果もちゃんと証明されてきてますので、新しいそういう領域で鍼灸が活用されるんじゃないかなというふうに思います。
Kasuya has also been studying the effects of moxibustion. Moxibustion involves placing dried mugwort leaves on acupoints and burning them to warm the area. It improves blood circulation and relieves pain.The after effects of stroke can include dizziness and unsteadiness. Kasuya has been treating patients with these symptoms by applying moxibustion to the soles of their feet to improve balance. He conducted an experiment to verify its effects. This device measures the distribution of body weight on the soles of the feet.Even a healthy university student can struggle to maintain balance while standing with eyes closed. His center of gravity shifts, causing him to sway.
Hey, okay. Hey, this one.
Kasuya applied moxibustion to the soles of his feet for about 10 minutes. He targeted areas known as mechanoreceptors.Mechanoreceptors are located on the soles and detect pressure and vibration. They transmit information to the central nervous system to help control posture and balance. After moxibustion, his balance was measured again. This is the data taken before the treatment.And this is the data taken afterward. The treatment helped to align his center of gravity, improving his balance.
呼吸をするとバランス機能が向上するというのは分かってきたので、今脳卒中の後遺症の方以外に、例えばめまい、あるいは手術をした後の術後の後遺症でしびれのある患者さんとか、いわゆるこうふらつきが結構ある患者さんに応用しています。
Would it be effective then also for something like Meniere's disease as well?
はい、メニエルの方、めまいとかを訴えている方は、これ前庭核といって、耳の中に異常を起こしてこうふらつきをする。実はメカノレセプターとか体の体表の刺激をすることで、これ体勢感覚というんですけれども。体勢感覚を刺激することで前庭核の異常を補ってあげる、フォローしてあげるっていう、まあ、そういう効果が期待できるんですね。ですからめまいのメニエール病なんかのめまいの患者さんでもそういうメカノレセプターの刺激をこうしているといったところですね。
These images show the improvement in symptoms of atopic dermatitis after about 10 months of acupuncture and medication. This patient had severe itching and hard lumps on her hands and feet, which didn't improve with medication alone. She decided to try acupuncture as well. More people with atopic dermatitis are trying the treatment.This woman has had symptoms since birth and started having acupuncture sessions a year ago.
常にかゆさが頭の中にあって、なんか何やるにもかゆさとともにみたいな感じ、いろんなもう結構 あらゆる治療をや、治療っていうか薬もやったし、いいかなと思っても長続きしない感じ。
Before starting treatment, acupuncturists ask patients about their health in detail.
微妙に寝れてない感じが。
寝れてない感じがする。
かゆみなのかは分かんない
です。とにかく睡眠の質としては全体的にはちょっと悪い。仕事の量であったり、勉強の量であったり、いわゆるストレスとか。そういうのは
めちゃくちゃある。なんかやることが遅すぎちゃって全然間に合ってかなくて、それでなんかイライラして。
イライラする。でその他、かゆみ以外気になることってありましたか？
喘息まではいかないんだけど。なんか苦しい。
During this session.Tsuji targeted not only the acupoints for improving skin condition, but also for relieving stress.
手の甲のところにある合谷であったり、足の甲のところにある対象であったり、特にストレスによるかゆみの場合は有効だと思って使っています。
The connection between overall health and eczema.Was a significant focus for a researcher who once mentored Tsuji. Egawa Masato has been using acupuncture to treat atopic dermatitis for over 20 years.
私はずっと長い間多くのアトピー性皮膚炎の患者さんを見るにつけ、皮膚の症状ばかりではないということに気がつきました。まあ不眠と肩こり。冷えの症状、精神的なイライラ、あるいはまあ女性なら生理不順、こういったものを抱えている体全体の歪みがあって、その上にアトピー性皮膚炎が乗っている、そして多くの患者さんはそのことについて、治療が行われていない、こうした体全体の状態を整えることが逆にアトピー性皮炎の症状を緩和することにつながっているのではないかなと私は今そう思っています。
Egawa is trying to objectively measure how well acupuncture works for treating atopic dermatitis. One of the indicators he uses is the level of IgE antibodies in the blood. IgE antibodies help to remove foreign substances from the body. High levels of these antibodies worsen the symptoms of eczema.Experts believe an excessive reaction against foreign substances causes skin inflammation. Egawa examined patients' blood after acupuncture sessions to check their IgE antibody levels. He found the levels dropped in 91.7% of those who saw a significant improvement in symptoms.This was much higher than in those who had minor or no improvement.
鍼灸治療は自律神経を介して IgE 抗体の産生を抑えて、そして1型アレルギーを緩和している。まあ、こういう基準を、まあ、仮説として立てているというところでございます。
The woman receiving acupuncture and medication for the past year has gradually seen her symptoms improve. She has been recording her symptoms using a survey provided by her acupuncturists. She receives a score based on 7 questions about the frequency of symptoms over the previous week.At the start of treatment, her score was 20, showing she had severe eczema. Her latest score was 6, indicating mild symptoms.
常に痒かったっていうのがどっか頭の隅にあったやつがそれがなくなったりとか、あとは常に本当にカサカサカサカサ体の中からしてたのがすごい変化がありました。
And I guess, Professor, what challenges do you think that acupuncture, working together with Western medicine, what challenges do you think it faces?
それぞれの領域のそれぞれの治療っていうのはきちっと役割があって、例えば、薬、それからリハビリ、それから看護師のケアとか、みんな役割持ってるんですね。ですから鍼灸もそういうチーム医療の中でちゃんと鍼灸がこういうところに役立つというのを鍼灸師がちゃんと出していく必要があると。例えばもうお薬が飲めない患者さんに針をすることで、痛みをより緩和させる、それから、薬のその副作用の吐き気とか、あるいはこう末梢神経障害とかも針をすることで軽くしてあげる、いわゆる鍼灸の役割って絶対ありますから、それをきちっとそれぞれの症状に対して提示していく、その辺が重要なんじゃないかなというふうに思います。
Dr. Thank you so much for your time today. 今日はどうもありがとうございました。
どうもありがとうございます。
Today, we will learn self-care techniques to ease various types of pain from Edward Obeidi, a licensed practitioner of acupuncture and moxibustion in Japan. The first technique is for headache relief. We will use moxa sticks, which warm the acupoints without touching the skin. This type of moxibustion is available online.
Yeah, it comes from a herb. In English, it's called Artemisia vulgaris. And in Japanese, we call it Yomogi.
Yomogi.
The main reason that they use Yomogi is the heating curve is very calm and regular. It's not explosive. And so you can warm things up. So it's a very good herb to use.
The acupoints targeted will vary depending on the location of the headache. For pain at the front of the head, use shoyo at the index finger nail's lower corner on the thumb side. For pain on the sides of the head, target kansho. It's at the ring finger nail's lower corner on the pinky side. And for pain at the back of the head, focus on shotaku at the pinky nail's outer bottom corner.
And when you use this, you put your finger in between it so that you're not going to burn her finger. And the hottest part is here. And basically, I hold it here about 1 centimeter away, and she tells me when it's hot.
And how hot? I mean, it feels quite warm, but not hot, hot.
Yeah, when it gets to a sharp heat, okay. You tell me, because it's actually quite pleasant, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very nice.
Yeah, and if you did this, say, 2 or 3 times a week, then actually when it's not painful, then you could probably prevent a full headache coming on.
And Edward, for people who don't have access to moxa, could you just, as you
press
mentioned,
it.
Just press it?
Yeah, literally like this.
Okay, so quite gentle, so it's
yeah.
not painful.
No.
Okay.
Don't go too strongly, because
okay.
the main thing is to sensitize, to get
okay.
the link between
yeah.
up here,and this meridian going, so just press it lightly.
The second technique is for menstrual pain. Target san inko, located about 4 finger widths above the inner ankle. This acupoint is a meeting point for the meridians connected to the liver, kidneys, and spleen.Warm the point with moxa sticks.
Then you want a gap of about 1 centimeter or 1.5
okay.
centimeters. And just wait until it warms up nice and slowly.
So when you're warming up this specific point, what action is it having in the body?
It's going into these 3 meridians. And they will fill up and affect the organs inside, and then when they're full up, you will feel heat.
If you don't have access to Moxa, gently press on the acupoint for 3 seconds and then release for 3 seconds. Repeat this process.
And would you do it on both sides?
Yes.
Okay, great.
So everything we've done on this side,
yes, repeat it on the other side.
The third technique is for lower back pain. The target is Jingyu, located at the narrowest part of the waist, about 2 finger widths away from the spine. This point helps to relieve fatigue. First, lie on your stomach.
Next important thing we need is this, hot water bottle.
A hot water, just a regular standard hot water bottle.
Yeah. All we need to do is we just put it here. And we can just, if they're not that weak and it's not that painful, then what we can do is we can start to do some very light massage. I don't know if you can see this, but I'm just moving the muscles back and forth, back and forth. And you're not pressing hard, because sometimes if you press hard, it can irritate the problem and make it worse.
So for those who don't have a hot water bottle at home, what could you do instead?
We have the answer.
Ooh. A bottle of water?
Yeah, but with hot water.
Oh, you've got hot water in there.
Yeah,
okay, that's a
like
great
idea. That?
That's very ingenious. Yeah. Brilliant.
You can also roll a plastic bottle containing hot water over the painful parts of your lower back and legs. Make sure to cover yourself afterward with a towel or other item to stop the heat from escaping.
I guess the key point, is finding the right point as well.
Yes. When you first find it, you're never going to be 100% correct anyway. But if you get roughly in that area and you do the Moxa, which isn't pinpoint, you'll be okay. And with the bottle and the hot water bottle, even more so, you don't really have to worry too much about getting it spot on. And over time, you'll feel it anyway.
It was brilliant, fantastic. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. It was good to talk to you.
ありがとうございます。
どういたしまして。